I am going to help you make your flowers last a lot longer. When you buy flowers, think of them like ice cream. Immediately drive them home. Don't stop somewhere else because just that heat in the back seat of the car or the trunk is going to kill them right away. Remember, most of your flowers have already been out of water from anywhere from 2 days to 2 weeks and then placed in plastic like this. So now we take them home, and the very first thing we want to do is get a nice clean vase or pitcher or bucket or something, put nice clean water in it, and most of your flowers are going to come with a little packet of flower freshener. Very, very important to use. Now, if you weren't lucky enough to get flower freshener with your flowers, we'll just put the whole packet in. That the flowers won't get the bacteria that really help rot them a lot faster. So you could use bleach. However, bleach is not going to be good for nice colorful flowers like this. I'd use them on lighter flowers like this because they will start to fade your flowers. But it does help kill the bacteria. And now I need to get each flower in the perfect condition. This is before we're making an arrangement. This is actually conditioning a flower for at least an hour before we put it into the vase that it's going to live in. The less leaves, the better for a flower, although you want some leaves. Now, I would just hold up a tulip like this and see any leaves that's looking a little wimpy, not great, I would just pull right off, like that. That actually might be enough. You could go one more leaf, it's up to you. Oh, and look, a little damage on that, not going to like that anymore either. So now we're down to just that. Now, don't do that on every single leaf. But that's a good start. So now I'm going to do a few more of them. Just pull them off. It's a little like kneading bread, too. The faster you do it, the better it's going to be for the flower. They don't like a lot of folding. Now I've got about 4 or 5 of them ready to go. Look at the bottom of these tulip stems. You see how they get a little bit more white near the bottom? That's because that's been out of water long enough that that white has happened. So when you cut them, definitely want the cut to be above the white. And with tulips, they're easy to cut, so I cut all of them at the same time. Are you ready for that? One big, nice, sharp angle to